Hi, my name is Brianna Lamar, and this is my studio, and I'm just now heading outside to start a little plein air still life painting just outside my studio. So I have a lot of little potted plants in my place here in Southern California, and it's a nice sunny day. So today I set up this right here. This is a sage plant. It's not a white sage, but it's similar looking to a white sage. And then I just have a little cup of tea here. That's just for me. So I'm just gonna paint this little guy here. I think he's pretty cute. I don't think I'm gonna paint the pot. I'm just gonna do the leaves and just do a quick little color study outside here in this beautiful afternoon. Okay, so it's super dark in the shadows. No, it's not like exposing. So here I am. I got my palette out. And here's my cat. he's chilling. So I just wanted to say that let's see if we can get a shot on here. It's hard to move my camera on the tripod. Focus. Okay, so you can see right there my color is a little bit, it's kind of in the shadow, but I'm kind of experimenting with my palette. So I've got these really interesting, beautiful colors here. These ochre colors, all different kinds, and this is Italian mineral pigments. This is a really high quality oil company that I like, but there's a lot of their paints I haven't tried yet. So this is a certain line. There's all these different classic earth colors. So I just put a few of those on my palette and I'm just kind of experimenting. So I don't really know. It's kind of an exploration process for me to see, just working with like these different earth tones, and I thought they might work well for this sage. And it's interesting, so I started with the yellow ochre. I'm going to start with that just to do like the basic silhouette of the sage. And it's kind of gritty, which is interesting because the other paints I've used of theirs are not gritty. There's like dust on the camera lens. Oh, there! It was like light for a second. Anyways, so I'm gonna get started with that. So that's what's happening. And you probably notice the bells. I'll show you my bells I got right here. This is pretty awesome. I don't even know how old this is. It's probably from Japan. I inherited it. It's really, really cool. I love it. I love antiques. I'm obsessed. And this is just a cute little charmy thing. So that's what you'll hear in the background. Alright, let's try to set this up. Alright, I'm gonna get painting. Something like that. Okay. Sorry, it's so dark. So I just did the first layer really quickly. It's pretty rough, just to get the general layout. And yeah, I went pretty gold on the background. I didn't mean to do it that gold, but I just went with it because I thought it's pretty, and I don't know, it might have some nice effects in certain areas where if it's more transparent, it kind of shows through and expresses that golden light off the pavement. I don't know. We'll see. It doesn't really matter. I can cover it up either way. I'm just kind of experimenting. Yeah. But the sun is getting right on my face, so I have to go get a hat on. I got my hat on. The shade is encroaching in, so I'm trying to get the backlit sun on the plant, on the leaves, because I think that looks best. So the sun's coming right at me. I'm under a tree, but it's angling. So hopefully I can start getting the colors in before the shade comes in. I'm gonna show you where my faucet is. No. You see him? Phase three. Okay, I'm talking to myself because I really like the terra verte so far. It's nice. But I am mixing it with white, and it's like I can hardly even see it. It has extremely low tinting strength, meaning I put it in there and it doesn't do very much. Like, way less than if I put in like a cadmium yellow and an ultramarine or a phthalo blue. So, I mean, it's very strange. It's a really pretty color. I need some really nice soft greeny white, so I think it will work okay. I just have to use a lot of it. Anyways, that's interesting. Mixing is probably the hardest part. So I really wanted the previous background with the light, not the shadow. It's pretty much all in shadow now. But I'm gonna try to I'm trying to match what's back in the background and just do that behind it instead. So I don't know, see how it goes. Sometimes I hold my breath.
Thank you.
wrap it up. Oh boy, let's see. How did I... Design with this pointy Q-tip, because there's no way I can do it with a brush. It's this small. Let's see, should I do it here? Okay, so I just finished, and here is the end result. You can see there. So yeah, that was fun. I hope you guys enjoyed that little painting session out here on my patio, painting the little sage and experimenting with the different colors that I was experimenting with. And yeah, if you'd like to check out my work, you can check it out on my website at briannalamar.com. I also have an art shop online, which I hope to be adding some more stuff to pretty soon, and that's at lucidlush.net. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed this. Let me know what you think about it. And yeah, if you'd like to see more, please join me, follow along. And yeah, thank you. Thank you, and have a lovely day.